Now here we have a table. It doesn't really matter what's in the table as far as this demonstration goes, but let me just explain what's here quickly. So it's a contact database of tradespeople. It shows what they're called, so first name and last name, where they live, when the entry was logged, what car they drive, what their trade is, what their hourly rate is, and how many jobs they've been allocated. So just a mixture of text, dates, and numbers. All the common stuff you'll be working with on a day-to-day basis if you use tables. Now at the moment, the data is sorted into suburb order. So A to Z on suburb. Now what we're going to do in just a second is to resort this table into a different order, simply. But before I do that, let me show a misconception, a common thing that people do before they do their sort process. And that is to select the whole table. Now you don't need to select the whole table before you sort. That's just a wasted step. The other thing that people do, which is even more dangerous, is they'll select a column of data within the table. Now Excel will warn you before it does this, but if you go ahead and ignore the warning, it actually just sorts that column and leaves everything else static. And so everybody will be allocated a new trade if you were to do that. So don't ever do that. Okay, that's the second thing you shouldn't do. To sort simply, let's say you want to sort it by hourly rate, you simply click a single cell in that column, go to your data tab, find the sort and filter group, and click either A to Z or Z to A, depending on whether you want the highest rates first or the lowest rates first. And that's it. Maybe you want to resort this list into trade order. So you click a single cell in the trade column, click either A to Z or Z to A, and again, it's sorted your list properly. Every row stays intact. Every trade belongs to the person it belonged to before, which is what you want. Now, you quite often need to do multi-dimensional or multi-level sorts. Let's say, for example, you want to sort first of all by state, and then by trade, and then within each trade, put the hourly rates into order. Now for this, you need to go to the big sort button at the top. This opens up another dialog box with a few more options. And what we do first is we sort by the top level item, which is state. Values A to Z, that's good. We then add a level, and on this one we choose trade. Values A to Z again, that's good. And then one last level, so we add, and then we choose hourly rate, values smallest to largest. Because hourly rate is numeric, it shows smallest to largest rather than A to Z, but it's still sorting into order. If we click OK now, have a quick look at the data. You'll see the states here are blocked. You'll see within each state, the trades are blocked up. And then for each trade, it shows the hourly rates in order. So that's a three-way sort, a three-level sort. Very easy to do. Another thing you'll see here, which you may or may not recognize, in the jobs column, you've got these icons next to each number. Now this is created using what's called conditional formatting. That's another whole topic. But basically, every number has been assigned a color or a symbol. If you want to sort the list into color order rather than value order, it's very easy. So you can start anywhere in the table. Click the big sort button. We're going to remove the existing levels. So delete and delete. And on the one that's left, we're going to choose to sort by jobs. Now, rather than sorting on values smallest to largest, we're going to change that to say cell icon. And it shows the icons over here. And we're going to put red on the top. Now, in a minute, we're going to do a couple of other levels. But just take a note that in that list, there's also cell color and font color. So if you want to do either your own manual formatting or manual tagging, or use some of the tools like finding duplicate values or conditional formatting, you can color code your cells and then sort by color, either font color or cell color. To continue this example, we're going to add two more levels here. So we put red on top already. Now to add the extra levels, you could add level and then reconfigure the next one. But there's also a copy level button which duplicates or clones the current level. So we're going to click that twice. And then all we've got to do for each one is to change the red to yellow and the red to green on each subsequent row. So it now shows red on the top, then yellow on the top, then green on the top. And because black's the only thing left, it will default to the bottom, which is what you want. So when we click OK, you will see traffic light sequence. It's ordered by color. So you can do that for any icon set, any color that you come up with. Sometimes you don't want to rely on A to Z or Z to A, either alphabetically or numerically. you want to put stuff in your order, your particular order. So maybe there's some elements that are more important than others, and you want to put them to the top of the list, even though they're not alphabetically first. To do that, you create what's called a custom order. So click in anywhere in the table, click the sort button, get rid of the second level, and what I'm going to do here is to sort on the trade. We're going to base it on values, but rather than going A to Z, I want to create my own order. So maybe I want to put plasterers first, and then roofers, and then brickies, and then plumbers. So instead of A to Z, I choose custom list. You'll see some existing entries, the days of the week, the months of the year, and both the short and the long versions of those. They're built into Excel, so they're existing lists you could use. What we're going to do in the list entries box is to put our custom list in for the order we want our trades to be listed. So let's put plasterer first, and then roofer, and then bricky, and then plumber. Okay, it's got to match what's in the table, so make sure there's no typos. Click Add. It adds it to the left-hand list there, and we can now click OK. You'll see the list is being used there as the order, and then click OK. So now if you look at your trades list, there's your plasterers, then your roofers, then your brickies, and then your plumbers. The final thing I want to show you is how to sort your columns into order. And mostly when I ask people how they do this themselves, they'd say, well, you just cut and paste or copy and paste. You have to insert your columns, you have to paste it all in. Often that goes wrong, you have to tidy things up, hacking stuff around. Be careful, you can make it work. But let me show you a more elegant way to go here. Notice the blank row above the table. We're going to use this to put a number sequence in above the main headings. So let's assume that we're interested in, say, first name and last names. They can stay. But maybe we want to put trade and hourly rates in columns 3 and 4. And then maybe everything else can just stay where it is. So for this, we would choose 1, 2, 3, 4, or whatever order you want to do for any column. Anything you leave blank, it just falls into its natural order. So just the four columns here is what we're after. We then select that whole row of numbers and the entire table. Now, I know I mentioned it earlier, you should never select your whole table before sorting. But in this instance, you have to, because if we don't, it won't recognize that row 1 as part of the table, and we won't be able to use it for our sorting. So now it's all selected. We'll go back to data if you need to. Click the sort button. Now, if you look at the sort by, it's currently showing the column letters within the spreadsheet. So column B, column C, column D. That is of no use to us at this stage. So the first thing we're going to do, and this is the key step, is to go to Options, sort left to right, which means we're now sorting columns into order, rather than top to bottom, which is rows. Click OK, and the sort by options now change to Excel row numbers. And what it's asking is, within the range you chose, which of those rows contains your sort sequence? And for us, that's row 1 at the top there. So the numbers are going to get used. Based on the values smallest to largest, that's the way it's going to sort. So we click OK, and you can see now, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you see the table has reordered neatly. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, and 4 is the first four columns we wanted. The rest are just in a natural order. You may have noticed a couple of things. Firstly, all the original column widths stay where they are. It's just the data that gets moved. Okay, so things like the street is now in a narrow column. You'd have to resize all of these. Quickest way to resize everything is to click the block in the corner between 8 and 1. That selects every cell on the sheet. And then just go to any column divider between any two columns and double click. That best fits each column separately. Okay, so we've been through quite a few things there. Let me just recap briefly. There's quite a few common mistakes that people make, and I hope they're clear now. You shouldn't be either selecting the whole table or selecting an individual column before you sort. Just select a single cell if it's a one column sort you want to do, or go to your data tab and the big sort button if you want to do more than one level. We've talked about how to sort by value, so numerically or alphabetically. We can sort by cell color or font color or cell icon. We can create a custom order, like we did for trade, to put things into a particular order. We've covered how to deal with duplicates, and then what we just did, which was to sort the columns into order. So hopefully you picked a few gems out of that video, a few value bombs. Now, if it has been useful, I would also appreciate if you subscribe to the channel, or if you could like if you're in Facebook, or if you want to connect in any way at all, keep watching, the details will follow. But that's it for today. Have yourselves a great day. Enjoy.